You notice Kevon looking slimmer this year, playing a bit quicker out there? Kevon Moore.
He looks good. I know he's working hard all offseason. He gets body right. Obviously, training camp was just getting started, so everybody's getting their legs. But, the work that he's done all offseason is pretty evident. And hopefully that shows and he produces on the floor like we know he can. No matter kind of where he fits into the rotation, he's giving himself a really good chance to be successful.
Is today your first kind of scrimmage day you had?
No, we've done, I think every day we've done a little bit of scrimmage. And it just depends on how coach wants to divide the minutes and the games we play. But it's been a very competitive camp so far. Our practices are 2 hours long, so they're really efficient. And we're out there, the intensity's at a very high level. There's obviously a lot of guys, so there's a lot of mixing and matching of the lineups, which is good. Kind of just see how different guys fit together. As we put in our offense, I shouldn't say put in our offense, we have our fundamentals and just getting refreshed on our basic sets that we run. The scrimmages have been really intense because everybody knows the plays we're going to run. And you're battling against that, and so it's been really fun. A lot of talking, a lot of high level plays. It's been good.
Is Kurt splitting you and Kevin mostly those scrimmages?
Yeah, we played together one, I think Tuesday, no, Monday. I think the start lineup hasn't been together at all. So like I said, it's good to kind of get a rhythm with everybody kind of mix and match and not knowing what to expect from game to game from day to day. And then when we get into actual preseason games, we can get back to that starting lineup and rotation that we'll expect the rest of the season.
Since more of these, Kevin, this time around after so much attention was on him, and how's he going to act?
Yeah, I mean, it's been really smooth. There's a chemistry and a certain expectation of how we're going to play versus last year, like you said, and a couple of unanswered questions going into camp and a feeling out process. But the coaches challenged us to focus on the details and how we can get better from last year. He joked around today, like, what do you tell a team that's won 67 games, 65 plus the last 3 years, two championships, and how do you tell a team like that to get better? What do you tell a team like that to get better? And it's basically about just the details to find points of our offense and cutting more and setting screens for each other. The counters that we're going to add to our offensive sets, all those little things are built on the foundation we set last year, and obviously Kevin's a part of that. And we all are, so it's kind of good to put that into the right perspective.
President Trump has tweeted more than 20 times since he called you out by name about the sports protest. Most recently, he said that the kneeling isn't about race. I'm wondering if you think, for you, that those expressions, including yours about the White House, are about racial inequity.
Yeah. That's the genesis of our stance. And you watched us all last year for us. We stood in the national anthem. Certain teams locked arms and had different demonstrations in the NFL, and taking a different approach, but it's about the message, it's not about that. And for the life of me, that doesn't just get across to everybody. It's not disrespecting anything about the flag or the anthem. And we can hopefully move in the right direction. So,
Steph, you've been an advocate for Kaepernick this entire time, and the Sports Illustrated cover, you're right in the middle, but there's no sign of Kaepernick. How do you feel about that?
That was terrible. She's kind of capitalizing on the hoopla and the media and all that nonsense. And the real real people that understand exactly what's been going on. And he's really been active and vocal and truly making a difference. If you don't have Kaepernick front center on that, something's wrong. So it's kind of hard to see how certain narratives take place being prisoners at the moment. So I was kind of joking around yesterday when I saw that on a certain Instagram handle, but at the end of the day, that stuff really doesn't matter. It's about the true message and really highlighting the people that are doing the right things.
Steph, what are there any plans at this point for how you guys handle Saturday if they have them?
We haven't talked about it as a team, but I don't know, to be honest with you. We understand exactly that we have all eyes on us when we go out there before the game on Saturday. And as our organization said, everybody has the right to do what they want to do and to voice what they want to voice and stand for what they want to stand for. And that'll all show on Saturday.
Shooting competitions have been still as close as they were.
You got a great memory. That's you're doing your homework.
First fridge?
That's pretty good. Yeah, okay. He's a scoreboard.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, are they still pretty close? I mean, I know it's early in the season.
Yeah. I honestly don't know exactly what the standings are when it comes to that, but we always challenge each other. And I think the best thing about it is we both get mad when we miss a shot because you know. Right. In that competition that we had, if you miss a shot, you're probably gonna end up losing whatever spot or whatever drill you're doing. So every shot's important, which for us can transition into the game because you have that certain focus and expectation that you're gonna make every shot and put a little bit of pressure on yourself while you can and practice in these situations.
You're gonna have that rematch with Horse like last year when KD beat you in Horse. When's that rematch going down?
I forgot about it. I appreciate you reminding me. I have to put that on the dot.
What do you think of Sunday and all the NFL players like protesting? And do you think they got the narrative right? What was your thoughts on just how Sunday of the week three of the NFL went down?
Obviously, they had a chance to respond to a terrible comment regarding just their presence in the NFL. What they stand for. I think for the most part, guys took advantage of that opportunity. You can kind of critique and nitpick and whatever, who did what, and that's again distracting from the true reason people are taking a stand and doing what they feel is right. And so it was awesome to see, just like how NBA rallied around each other and the players had each other's back. No matter really what you believe, it's just about respect and just understanding how powerful our voice is. So I think the NFL, those guys really took that leadership and it was awesome to see.
Have you seen the re-invitation from Pelosi on Twitter yet?
I did see that yesterday. And like I said, it's all about spreading love and support. And thank Nancy for making that gesture. And obviously, we're going to figure out what we're going to do exactly in February. And hopefully, we can rally a lot of people from a lot of different backgrounds and a lot of different situations to share the same message.
Great. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks, Steph.
Thanks, Steph.